When I was a kid, family, my mother, my father, my brother, it's rather a semi-dysfunctional family, and I became relatively isolated, and I took a space, a personal space, that had to do with sound. Sound in my head when I was with other people, spacing out, just in a sound world. Wasn't necessarily music at that time. I'm talking about like when I was 8, 9, 7 years old. We lived during a period in the far woods in southern Oregon. I spent quite a bit of time out in the woods alone. And I had my friends, the trees and so on, but it was the sound that got me. I didn't realize it at the time, but I do now, looking back on those years. And then I met the double bass and I started playing. I was just the end of my 13th year, a few months after starting playing the bass, I was 14. And there, I really got into the sound world and playing. I started listening to music then a little bit later due to an older brother, Peter, who brought home Stravinsky, Bartok, jazz. And I loved it. I loved it very much. Because I would go away. I'd go away into the sound and be so happy. And playing, when I was playing, I was so happy. I'd become completely oblivious to what was going on around me and just be in the sound. And I stayed in that sound world while carrying on with an apparently reasonable, healthy, good life until the age of about 25. And when I was 25, I couldn't be reasonable and a healthy American life. And I gave up my academic studies to just do music full time. And since then, that's over 50 years now, that's what I've been doing, is doing music full time. And this condition of being able to get into the sound with the help of this instrument, the double bass, other instruments that I'll play with in orchestra and grooves through the years, is constantly giving me this great joy of being in the sound, and for many years now, also be able to create. Around 1975, I was on stage with John Serman, Stu Martin, and I came to a great realization that here I was in my sound world having a wonderful time, and that the place we were playing was full of people who came to share that, to listen to it. And they got something from that, and I had no idea what they were getting, because I was just in my sound world having a good time and enjoying it. And I was being materially supported. take this way of just playing music. It gave me my life. It allowed me to have a family to some degree. And so I started to say, well, what is going on? What is it that I'm doing that attracts people, that tells them that they want to come, pay money, give me money to hear what I'm playing and what I'm going to play? It's led me on a very long road, which is still going on now, to understand, try to understand what is music, what happens in a concert, and what do we get from an inspiring concert, an inspiring musical experience.